Here's the basic truss. The problem is to solve for the forces on each member and determine if the members are in tension or compression. First thing to always do is solve for external forces. There's no horizontal load, so there can't be a horizontal reaction at C, so that'll drop out. Finding these external forces usually requires summing moments about a point. Let's sum moments about point A. The 100-pound force has a lever arm of 9 feet in the negative moment direction. And CY has a lever arm of 21 feet in the positive moment direction. The reaction in C will equal 42.85 pounds. Next is summing forces in the Y direction to find the reaction at A. Now that all the reactions have been found, we can begin method of joints. Beginning at any joint will suffice, so why not start at A? AB and AC have been drawn assuming they pull on joint A. They'll fix themselves later if we're careful with the signs. Draw on the components. Sum the forces in the Y direction first because this will utilize the known force. Next is using ratios to substitute the Y component. Simple Pythagorean theorem being used here. Notice how these units and the dimensions cancel out. This is a signal that the ratios was done correctly. The answer came out negative, so what does that mean? The force is drawn in the wrong direction. The signs of our answers only tell us direction, nothing more. Doesn't the free body diagram make more sense now? Next, sum forces in the x direction. We have all the forces at this joint, so let's move some around. So when transferring forces from the joint to the member, the forces applied equal and opposite. Now to keep that member in equilibrium, the exact same forces must be placed on its other side as well. This is a visual aid to see members in compression and members in tension. When transferring forces from the member back to the next joint, the force is applied equal and opposite again. Now we can analyze joint B or C by drawing a new free body diagram. Let's do B. Since we transferred a force, we transferred its components as well. Draw on BC's components. Now apply the laws of equilibrium. So now that both of BC's components have been found, we can use those to find its magnitude. Let's transfer this force to C now. I'll walk through how to do this one more time. Apply the equal and opposite force, then the member, and lastly, mirror the two forces. So to sum it up, one force, member, two forces. Try to remember that when transferring forces on a truss. Okay, moving on. We can see here that BC is also in compression. Now that all the forces have been found, it's always nice to check the work. If the answers are correct, joint C's free body diagram will show in complete equilibrium. To solve for these components, we can use ratios. The 16.97 is the length for BC acquired using the Pythagorean theorem. We already know the value for BC, so that can be used here. Our answer is slightly off, but that's because some numbers are rounded during the calculations. Be careful of that. We can see that BC's components balance is joined to keep an equilibrium. Now we can be positive the answers are correct. Here's the complete result of the truss.